I did not see the first time when we were
having the presentation.
We
had a colleague was standing in for her.
Okay, that's
yeah, she's responsible for our program for the business management.
Yes. So, thank you for the opportunity. I would love to start with the introduction and a little bit about my background. I'm teaching bus, and I came in Abe 2015. I studied English. I could only speak French, so I studied English. It was a little bit challenge, and from there I went to UNA. I say, well, time has moved, I have to catch up. According to my age, I feel like I was a bit older. So I went to UNA, I was interested in entrepreneurship. And I did entrepreneurship and new venture management. And I obtained my diploma. And then from there, I say, no, let me go into management so I can combine these two. That is where I am now. And since when I came to NASA, I identified that there were an opportunity of where I can do my internship. So it was with Mr. Gilbert. We have tension at the beginning, and then he teach me how to be patient. And later on, I told him, he called me, I start assisting while it was not even an internship. Okay, then later on, he said no. I went, I saw him say, we are facing challenges in regard with internship as foreigners. He said, you can join me, but I was already planning to get other people. Then disqualify them and take me the opportunity to do the internship with him because of my past behavior and how I assist him. Yeah. So from there, I was under the department, it's under the register, the office of the register, but under the Faculty of Management and Science. I thought I'm going only to assist Mr. Gilbert, but in the office, we had two faculty officers plus the other one on this side, Ms. Nerina, Ms. Julius, and Ms. Yvonne. And yeah, all assist them because I wanted to extend myself. So, first of all, we started with registration when I just opened. Registration process, and at my first experience on registration, it was a big challenge because I knew what the process of registration was, but not at the extent where we face now students who are almost like my colleagues, and they are stressed about to get registration, and I have to handle them to protect my supervisor not to be too much in contact with students to avoid delay in the process. And I was really scared to carry all this document for students because sometimes they will say, no, I give you a form, then you lost it. Thank God that did not happen. I was very careful, and it was a really good experience in registration. And from there, we move on to exemption and amendment form. Exemption is the document where students want to exempt from or get credit or exempted from certain subjects they have done previously at any other institution. It seems easy, but it's a really, really stress job because now I got the form from EDMI. Basically, the EDMI people, they just took the exemption form and then you just fill up and then it's over for them. They will come and those forms, they give it to me. So I was in charge of all this exemption form. So I have to take all exemption from lecture to lecture or course coordinator to sign. And after that, I have to take it to the dean. From the dean, I have to take it to the HRD. And then from there, I bring it to my supervisor. We also take time to process them. And every day, we have students complaining. Until now, we are still having them. We only maybe finished yesterday. Because sometimes, some of the students, they end up, their subjects disappear from, we uncancel them in the system because it's a prerequisite that they took because of the exemption, which was not yet done. An amendment is also part of the when some student can bring their form to add a subject or changing the mode of full-time to part-time or as well as to change the mode of study. From entrepreneurship, I want to go to management, you also fill an amendment form. Yeah. consultation and inquiry, as I'm in, my background is a French, so then I find myself, people can only speak maybe Afrikaans. It was already a barrier for me. Now I only know maybe kindness, something like that to make them happy, and later on I jump in English. So I was not trying to make people feel like I cannot speak Afrikaans. I tried to put them in mind that we can speak English since we're at university, it's the official language, breaking the barrier. And inquiry, I received a lot of inquiry. I used to have a small book where I put early inquiry or papers, and then at the end I would drop it to Mr. Gilbert and he process them, or either to Ms. Mbako, or even Ms. Yvonne, Ms. Elise, anyone. So apart from that, I also faced the faculty administration. That is now inside job where someone will come or we feel filing the form. We have big form like that which in they contain the all the academic requirements. I think maybe most of the students doesn't know. They file like this way, like our program, let's say for our management, 2016. So all your files will be put there. Each year we print academic report, we edit them, we update. And we have also what we call promotion checklist. So the promotion checklist is where then we check from academic record plus promotion checklist, then I will identify that you are allowed to graduate or you have one more deal outstanding. And we keep that because sometimes the system can just shut down and then we lost all the database. So now we have to go back to the academic record and promotion checklist. We can be able to update again the marks of students. And also what we call the promotion checklist, also we also do it for students who are going to graduate. Okay, then I have to mix with student filing verification. It's come together. So I have a promotion checklist here, and I have done that for 400 and something students. Management, science, entrepreneurship, there were only two students, there were three who graduated. So it was a quite a big number, and my boss always repeats, no mistake. So I work overtime, which I did not mention there. So I will sit with promotion checklist, with student file verification. Student doesn't know, maybe for instance, you change a document that I always advise my fellow student Congolese. I say, be careful with your document you are submitting, that document stay forever. We have a file now, individual file can be like this. We are keeping all the record since day one of your registration. Who signed on that paper? Everything it keep there. So I went through all of this, and at the end I check your promotion checklist, and I put the paper is like an auditing. So I say you are maybe obtaining a degree or a honors degree. So I've done that for 400 and students. After that, we are doing also the graduation part. Before graduation, it starts from promotion checklist, student filing verification, and the graduation itself, that was the easy part, because the big part is when we're not even sleeping, so stress. Where we have to put the filing, like we put a document for student, we put the, again, we have to print the academic report, stamp them, sign them. My boss always say, I wish I could give you a signature that only missing here. Otherwise, everything you could do it. So I was very amazed by myself that I did a good job. And I have to identify that I have made one mistake. I put two academic report in one student file. So then we find it at the graduation and they said, no, this is not my thing. I was like, my boss just said me, I understand, it's the hard work and the time also. Yeah, graduation, it was also a good experience where I was identified as a junior faculty officer, working with all the sun. It was very good. And then direct student when they are graduating, I feel like I was already graduated while I still have two. So yeah, that is
the process that happens.
That the process.
Okay,
on the, yeah, on the recommendation, I realized that there was a problem with the exemption delay. So we advise that the administration, they must do their job. They must check if the student have really go to the lectures and sign if they are exempted or not, because they can stop that from there in order to give us that job. Yeah. And also in my conclusion, I honestly say that my time spent as an intern with Gilbert, Miss Marco, and everyone, it's not result of the best time of my life. Not only did I gain the practical skills, but I also had the opportunity to meet many fantastic people.
Okay.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you, Tony. So where will the future take you?
I really want to be an academic, but I have a niche in Congo. I would love to go there and assist my father with the farm that he created, the family business. Apart from that, I would love also to work in any company to gain experience as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, are you related to Exa?
Who?
Exa.
Axel, no. We are just friends.
Just colleagues.
Yeah. Okay.